Hello students, today we will discuss about the pharmacognostic study of fennel, which is commonly known as sonf in Hindi. So first is the synonym of this drug. It is commonly known as the Fructus fonicoli, fennel fruit, fennel, Florence fennel, sweet fennel, wild fennel, large fennel. And if we talk about the biological sources of this drug, it is commonly consists dry fruits of Foniculum vulgare, which is belong to family Umbelliferae. Okay, its botanical name is the Foniculum vulgare, whereas it's belong to family Umbelliferae, and its useful part is the fruit. And geographically, it is indigenous to Mediterranean countries and Asia, and largely cultivated in France, Saxony, Japan, Galicia, Russia, India and Persia. And if we talk particularly in context of the India, it is commonly cultivated in Gujarat, Punjab, Maharashtra and Rajasthan, and most of the supply of fennel in India is coming from the Gujarat. It is approximately 90%. So we can say that majority of the fennel is in India is cultivating in the Gujarat, and 90% of the supply is coming from the Gujarat. So the botanical name of this drug is the Foniculum vulgare, and it's belong to Umbelliferae, and it is the useful part is the fruits, and in Hindi it is commonly known as the sonf. So you have to remember the biological source. So in biological source you have to write the useful part of the drug and its botanical name and the family in which to its the drug is belong. So next slide is the, it is indicating the cultivations and the collections of the fennel. So if we talk about the plant, it is a beautiful plant, perennial umbelliferous herbs with yellow flowers and feathery leaves. Feathery means hair like leaves are present in the plant, and the color of the flower is the yellow. And mostly it is grow widely in many parts of the world in different countries, and commonly it is propagated by the seed propagation methods. And during the month of April, it is propagated by the seeds, and well drained calcareous soils is commonly suitable for the cultivations of the fennel, and it's also require abundance of the sunlight, and it is adapted to dry in sunny situations. So there should be the good arrangement of the sunlight whenever you want to cultivate the fennel, and particularly in that regions there should be proper arrangement of the light, and sunlight should be in good quality. And if we talk about the height of the plant, so the plant can be up to 2 meters in height, and it may be erect cylindricals and take enough space in the branching. So most of the branches bearing leaves cut into the very finest of the segments. So the leaves of the flower, leaves of the plants is the feathery, or we can say hair likes, and they take much more space. So there should be sufficient distance between the two plants. Like in this image you can see that this person is sowing the plants, and the difference between the two plants should be like this, because when this plant will grow, so leaves will occupy the more and more space. That's why there should be sufficient space, and these leaves are cut into a very finest of the segment. So slowly they are cut into the fine segment. Then the plant bear fruits in the second year after growing the plants. When it completed 2 years, so there will be the bearing of the fruits, and bright golden flowers will come. Flat terminal umbels blooms in the July and August. So in the month of July and August we can see the flowering of the plant, and the fruits are collected by cutting the stems in the September. So these fruits can be collected in the month of the September when the fruits became the matured. And stems are dried on a sieve under the sun and later beaten to separate the fruits. So we will take the stems and they will dry under sunlight, and then we will beat the stems to separate the fruits. In this way we can collect the fennel fruit. And next is the characteristics of the fennel fruit. So we can see here that it is the cremocarpic in nature. Cremocarpic means when we rub the drugs between our hand, so it will divide it into two equal part, and each part is known as the mericarp. So this is the cremocarp and this one is the mericarp. And if you see that this surface is known as the commissural surface or ventral surface, whereas this one is the dorsal surface. So fruit is an entire cremocarp with pedicels. Pedicels is the lowest part of the fruit, which is known as the pedicels. And you can see at the top of the fruit there is the apex, which consists the stylopod, which is bifid in nature, and we can see some ridges in the fruits, primary ridges and secondary ridges. Primary ridges are prominent and straight, so these are the primary ridges, whereas secondary ridges are in zigzag, but it is slightly in compared to secondary ridges. Primary ridges are more prominent. So size is 5 to 10 mm long, whereas 2 to 4 mm broad in nature. And particularly about the shape, it is oval oblong in shape. Color is greenish brown to yellowish brown in color, and it consists the stylopod. So it is all about the morphological features of the drugs. And if we talk about the microscopic features of the drug, so the transfer section, this diagram is showing the transfer sections of the mericarp of the fennel fruit. So here we can see that this portion is the ventral surface, or we can say the commissural surface, and this portion is the dorsal surface. And in dorsal surface there are the five ridges are there, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. You can see easily 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we can say on the dorsal surface there are 5 ridges, which is known as the primary ridges. And in each, below the each primary ridges, there is the vascular bundles are present. So we can say that the mericarp of the fennel fruit consists 5 vascular bundles, which are present below the primary ridges. So if we count 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, 5 number of vascular bundles are there, and these vascular bundles are covered by the fibers, due to which it is known as the fibrovascular bundles. Okay, these vascular bundles also known as the fibrovascular bundles because they are covered by the fibers, and the nature of the vascular bundle is the bicollateral vascular bundle. So if we ask to you that what type of vascular bundle is present in the fennel, so it is the bicollateral vascular bundle. Now what is bicollateral vascular bundle? So this diagram is showing the bicollateral vascular bundle. We can say simply just like a sandwich, that we will consider that we will make the sandwich of cucumber with bread. So we can consider that xylem as cucumber, as a xylem, jo aapka kheera hota hai usko humne maan liya xylem. And then in the lower side of the bread we will spread the some tomato ketchup. So this tomato ketchup we can consider as the cambium, both side, and bread will represent as the phylum. So xylem is there and it is covered by the phloem, and cambium is also present. So this type of vascular bundle is known as the bicollateral vascular bundle. And particularly about this mericarp, so this mericarp is divided into the pericarp and seed. There are two portions of the transverse section. First one is the pericarp, second one is the seed. So this one pericarp is again divided into the epicarp, mesocarp and endocarp. Epicarp is the outermost layer, middle portion is known as the mesocarp, whereas innermost layer is known as the endocarp. And whereas the seed portion is consists the testa, endosperms and embryo. Okay, and this epicarp portions, it is the single layer cell, it is the single layer cells containing the polygonal cells covered by the cuticle layers. Okay, after that there is the mesocarp. In mesocarp there is the parenchymatous tissues and it consists the vascular bundles. There will be 5 vascular bundles which are present below the primary ridges, and in this region some vitas are also present. If you see the numbering of vitas, 1, 2, 3 and 4, so we can say that on the dorsal surface there are 4 vitas are present, whereas on the ventral surface 2 vitas are also there. So in each mericarp there are 6 vitas, 2 on the ventral surface whereas 4 on the dorsal surface. Ventral surface is also known as the commissural surface. And in ventral surface, here you can see the carpophore, which is useful to attach the each mericarp because it is the half portion. If you see the morphology of the drug, this is the full fruit, whole fruit is here, but this portion is the mericarp. So it is the half portion, and this half portion is known as the mericarp, and this with the help of this carpophore, these both portions are attached with each other. And after that there is the after the mesocarpic regions there is the endocarp, which is the single layer, and it consists the percutary cells arrangement. Percutary cells arrangement is the means a group of cells which are parallelly arranged, so it consists the percutary cell arrangement. After endocarp there is the single layer testa is there, which consists the yellowish brown content. After that endosperms is there, and endosperms yellowish brown content is also present, and in the center of the endosperms there is the embryo. And on the ventral side we can see the raphe is also present. So these all are the important features of the microscopic characteristics of the fennel fruit. So important thing is that number of vitas are 6, out of which 4 present on the dorsal surface, whereas 2 on the ventral surface. And there are 5 primary ridges which are prominent in natures, and below the each primary ridges there is the vascular bundle, and vascular bundle is the bicollateral type of vascular bundle. So these are the some things which you have to remember about the microscopic features of the fennel fruit. And another thing is that this cremocarpic nature is the nature of the umbelliferous fruit. Umbelliferous fruits means the fruits which belong to umbelliferi family, and it is the major characteristics of drugs of the umbelliferi family that they divide into the two portions, and each portion is known as the mericarp. So it is all about the morphology and microscopic features of the drug, and these all are the points which I already discussed with you, that like the transverse sections of mericarp region of fennel shows 2 prominent surfaces, the dorsal surface and commissural surface. As I already told you that it consists 1 dorsal and 1 ventral surface. The commissural surface has a carpophore. So at the ventral surface there is carpophore and 2 vita, whereas on the dorsal surface there is 5 ridges are present. Five ridges are present, which is known as the primary ridges. Epicarp consists polygonal cells of epidermis, which are tangentially elongated and covered by the cuticle. Now, the meaning of the tangentially elongated means like the water waves. Have you seen the water waves? So these cells are arranged in such a way that tangentially elongated means just like the water waves, these cells are arranged. It is known as the tangentially elongated, and these cells are covered by the cuticles. Then mesocarpic portions has the parenchymatous cells with 5 bicollateral vascular bundles. Below each primary ridges, a lignified reticulate parenchyma surround the vascular bundles. So these vascular bundles are covered by the lignified reticulate parenchymatous cells. So it means when we will treat with the fluoroglucinol and hydrochloric acid, so it will give the pink color observations. When we will stain the drug with the fluoroglucinol and HCl, so it will be the identification test to find out the presence of the vascular bundle. And vascular bundle is the bicollateral type of vascular bundles. There are 4 beta on the dorsal surface and 2 beta on the commissural surface or ventral surface, as I already discussed with you. Inner epidermis or endocarp shows the perquiatory arrangement. Perquiatory arrangement means parallel cells, a group of 4 to 5 cells which are arranged parallelly at acute angles with the groups of similar cells in different directions. So these cells are parallelly arranged and in the different directions they are arranged. And testa is the single layer tangentially elongated cells with yellowish color. Endosperms consist thick wall, white polyhedral colorless cell content. Then cell contain fixed oils, aleurone grains, rosettes, calcium oxalate crystals. So about the calcium oxalate crystals, so rosette type of calcium oxalate crystals are present in the TS. So it is all about the microscopic features of the fennel. Now next is the chemical constituent. So major active constituent is the fancone and anethol are the major active constituents of fennels chemically, which are volatile oils. And this drug contain 4 to 5% of the volatile oils. And if we talk about the anethol, it is out of 50 to 60% of volatile oil of anethol, which is chemically phenolic esters, whereas fancone is 18 to 22%, and chemically it is ketone, and it is bicyclic monoterpenes, and it is colorless liquid having the pungent odor and taste and camphoraceous. And the oil of the fennel also consists beta pinene, anisic acid, phenandrine, anisic aldehyde. These are the other constituents, but fancone and anethols is the major active constituents of the drug. And fennel also contain about 20% of the fixed oils and 20% of the protein. Now the uses of the drug. So commonly it is used as the stomachic, aromatic, diuretic, carminative, diaphoretic, and as a digestive, pectorals, and as a flavoring agent. Anethol may have estrogen like activity and it inhibits the spasm in smooth muscles. Okay, whenever there is the spasm, so anethol may be helpful to inhibit the spasm. And fennel can also increase the productions of the bile, and it is used in the treatment of the infant colic, and it can also be used to promote the menstruations in the women, and can also increase the lactations. It is also act as the antipyretic, antimicrobial, and anti-inflammatory activity. So it is all about the fennel drug, which is commonly known as the SOMP. So you have to remember the botanical name, biological source of the drug. So biological source is Foniculum vulgare, which belong to Umbelliferi family, and most of the fennel is coming from Gujarat. It is 90% in India. And about, if we talk about the cultivations collections, so seed propagations method is commonly useful for the cultivations of the fennel, and calcareous soil is suitable for the cultivations of the drug. And here in microscopy you have to remember the number of vitae, which are 4 on dorsal surface and 2 on ventral surface. So total number of vitae are 6, and 5 vascular bundles are present, which are bicollateral in nature. And on the ventral surface there is one carpophore is there. And if we talk about the morphology, so primary ridges are prominent in nature and straight, whereas secondary ridges are very light, not easily visible in compared to the primary ridges. So it is all about the morphology and microscopy. So it is all. And then you have to remember the fencone and anethole is the major active constituents of the drug. So thank you very much for watching the video.